Hi there, I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong. Today I'm going to show you how to measure your blood sugar so you get an accurate reading in the first go and with as little pain as possible. So I've been living with type 1 diabetes since 97, so that's a lot of years of measuring my blood sugars. And I understand firsthand how important it is to have accurate readings. It's important for your diabetes management, especially if you manage your diabetes with insulin injections, but it's also important just to get a good gauge for how different kinds of foods impact your blood sugars. So also know that doing so many finger sticks can be really, really hard on your hands. It might even be painful, or you might have developed callus simply from all those finger sticks. So let me take you through three tips for accurate blood sugar measurements so that you can manage your diabetes, as well as three tips for reducing or minimizing any pain or discomfort. Getting an accurate blood sugar reading is so important, especially if you manage your diabetes with insulin like I do. If you get an accurate high reading, you might correct that with more insulin, and that could lead to severe low blood sugars. So, first tip for getting accurate blood sugar readings. First tip, wash your hands and dry them before doing any sort of blood sugar measurements. So we want you to wash your hands, preferably with warm water. Again, dry them off really well after, but warm water because, well, you might know this feeling when it's really cold, it can be really hard to get any blood out of your finger. So you might prick it and nothing happens because of the cold. So you can wash your hands, maybe even massage them a little bit. That'll make the blood flow. Second tip is, what if you're out and about and you don't have a sink around? You can just wash your hands. So my tip is to bring wet napkins with you so that you can actually wash down your hands with that. Some people will choose to use alcohol swabs in this situation. Generally, that's not really recommended. There's actually a really, really good study where scientists had a group of people measure the blood sugar and then peel fruit, and then wipe down their hands with alcohol swabs. So what happened was that all that fruit sugar was still on their hands after, and the readings came back really, really inaccurate. So whereas blood sugars might have been 90 milligrams per deciliter, the faulty readings came back in 200 milligrams per deciliter or 360 milligrams per deciliter, so significantly higher. So wash your hands either with a wet towel or with, you know, water and water and soap. So the third tip is, make sure that you get enough blood on that test strip. Some meters will give you an error message if there's not enough blood on there, some won't. Some of the meters will just return a blood sugar reading that's actually lower than what your blood sugar is. Getting an accurate blood sugar reading is, of course, everything. But equally as important is to reduce any pain or discomfort you might have. So my first tip for that is, measure your blood sugar from the side of your finger. I see so many people who will prick their fingers in the middle of their finger, which is probably one of the most painful places to draw blood from. So instead, place your finger pricker on the side of your finger, not in your nail, but on the side of your finger, either side, and gently squeeze out that blood drop. If your hands are really beat up, or maybe you're starting to have a lot of callus, use another place on your body. So earlobe, for example, some devices allow for the thighs or the arms, but there are other places to draw blood. Just remember that if your blood sugars are increasing or decreasing really rapidly, you will get the most accurate readings in your hands or the base of your, in your fingers or the base of your hands. Third, as I mentioned, there are some devices that allows you to measure your blood sugar from other places in your hands. So one of those is called Genteel, and I'll leave a link to Genteel down in the comments. I'll also link to a video I did of the Genteel product later on, But basically, this product allows you to measure your blood sugar pretty much from anywhere on your body. And instead of the poker going like really into your skin, it creates a little bit of a vacuum and kind of like gently sucks out the blood. So it's like a vampire device, but it can reduce pain significantly. So those were our three tips on how to get accurate blood sugar readings, as well as my tips on how to minimize any pain and discomfort. So I hope this will help you to get good accurate readings so that you can manage your diabetes to the best of your abilities. And let's get real here. I think if we can reduce the pain, if we reduce the discomfort, you're also more likely to measure your blood sugars more often. I hope you enjoyed this video on how to measure your blood sugars. If you did, give it a like. And please let me know down in the comments if you have any additional tips on how to get accurate readings with less pain, less discomfort. Thank you so much for watching.